my glove was pretty badly ripped, so I didn't wear them today. I ended up throwing them in the trash. Gonna take it easy today. Keep moving, but no pushing or anything like that. Big question is, does it hurt? Man, second day, all this sucks. I've discovered a bit of pain in my neck, but that'll work itself out. Just tension, mostly. Like I exercise my neck. Pain. And my shoulder hurts. So it's difficult to stand up while riding because that works the shoulder a lot. But I have full motion, so without a lot of pain, just a little bit. When I stress it, that's when it hurts. Right here. Naked without my gloves. This feels weird. And I don't want to wear my winter gloves today because it's already 90 something degrees. Today. I'm doing these long rides, and generally the video's about 30 to 45 minutes depending on how I feel. They're bumpy as can be. And then I've got the 3-minute fast rides, they're kind of fun. I'm thinking what I might do is just do what a lot of other people do, where it's just highlights. I'll go through and find out where I'm talking, cut those down, and just cut out the parts where I'm quiet, maybe, I don't know. Funny little graphics and stuff. Oh, the river down there is running good. Good morning.
Good morning.
Funny one. Why do I sometimes say good morning or good evening or good afternoon in English and other times in Spanish? I don't know. I guess in a way, either way, I'm somehow passing judgment on people, although I shouldn't. But it is kind of fun to see the surprise on people's face when I say hi to them in Spanish. Most of the time they like it, if they speak Spanish. I have said it to somebody who didn't speak Spanish once. And said, what? It's pretty funny. But only once. finally the sheetrock is gone. Sides. why didn't I go around the bus and say, hey man, get out of my lane? It wouldn't solve anything, just create an argument. That's it. He didn't do anything to hurt me. Now, if I had already been in the lane and he beeped at me to get out of the way, yeah, I might have a problem with that. And I might explain to him. I don't know if I'd explain to him that he's an idiot, but that's probably what I would do. But he didn't. Up in White Rock, British Columbia, they have a great share the road sign. It has a bicycle. It's like, it's kind of like an overhead view. It has a picture of a bicycle riding in front of a car. Basically what that suggests is bicycle belongs on the street and can take the lane. The ones that we have here have a rear view of a bicycle to the right of a car. And I don't like that because it suggests that at all times I need to stay to the right. And like for example right here, I'm not doing that. I'm moving over. directly behind me than I did as he was passing me. That's interesting. Parking over here, but it's not marked, so I can ride in it. But I'm up to the stop sign, so I'm gonna step out so that I don't. Let's see. Let's go up Ogden. Nice. definitely a Charger. Not sure what year, looks like maybe a 67. I think the 65 had a bit less back window. This way though. It's green.